just look at the stocks of Amazon or any other public e-commerce company out there, you're going to see that they have grown significantly because more and more people are now shopping online. Hello everybody, welcome to Search. This week we will talk about how to build an e-commerce SaaS tool or an add-on. If you're in the e-commerce space, if you're an e-commerce business owner, if you're an agency providing any kind of services for marketing or PR, you know that e-commerce is big now, especially after COVID. Everybody's trying to go 100% digital and e-commerce is a big part of this. Just look at the stocks of Amazon or any other public e-commerce company out there. You're going to see that they have grown significantly because more and more people are now shopping online. Now, Joe, we have built, as Optimum 7, we have a development department and we have a marketing department. So we started as a marketing agency, but in the past 7 years, we're deep into development. And I would say 90% of this development is e-commerce related. And we have built our own add-ons. When we say add-ons, we're talking about apps for Shopify, apps for BigCommerce, apps for Volusion, Magento add-ons, WooCommerce plugins. And we have also built our own APIs. We have also built our own SaaS solutions. Why would anybody need to build an e-commerce SaaS solution or an add-on? Let's start with that now. Why is the industry so hot right now for these types of technologies?
Yeah, so I think with the increase in volume that we've been seeing in e-commerce also comes now some pain points that might have never been exposed before. So I think that that's why we're getting a lot more phone calls saying, hey, we're having this issue. We're going to need some sort of technology, whether it be an add-on or whether it be a third-party app or an API integration to solve this issue. I think it's mainly because of the volume that we're seeing that it's opening the store owner's eyes to the issues that they never thought they had before.
Yep, got it. And what we call these is niche SaaS solutions or micro SaaS solutions. Micro SaaS is a term that we came up with Joe probably 2-3 years ago. So when we build an app or an add-on or a SaaS solution like this, we don't expect to have more than 1,000 customers because it addresses a very, very key specific business point or technical point, and it solves a very specific problem. And we don't think that the value for the e-commerce business owners out there, regardless of them being on Shopify, BigCommerce, Magento, or WooCommerce, is not going to be that much. So only about, I would say, 1,000 to 3,000 people will pay you $100 per month for this type of tool to fix their current business problem or operational problem. And therefore, we call them micro SaaS solutions. Now, Joe, let's talk about some of these things that we've built and what they address. I mean, as you said, we probably get 20, 30 new requests on a weekly basis of, hey, I need A, B, C, D. And we literally need to look at the feasibility of making that possible. We'll share one that we got this past week. There's a prospect that wants to save search results on his website and create alerts for those search results because he thought that that would be the solution to informing his clients or customers of new products or results. Now, when we think about a functionality like this, we would need to build a backend admin. We would need to build a third-party database. And other than the feasibility part of this, it's important if it actually makes sense. I mean, we get requests for gift registries, for baby registries. We got one request where we needed to merge the gift registry with the in-store iPhone, iPad pickup kind of functionality. So we get some crazy functionalities. Talk to us about FFL API because this is a good example. It's very niche. It's very unique. What is that project all about?
Yeah, no, that's definitely a great example. And what I like the most about the FFL API, because like, as you said, right, these SaaS solutions are going to be for a very niche industry. So we're not going to get tons of requests. However, each and every one of these clients that come to us all have the same exact pain point, and all of them have hundreds, if not millions, of customers coming to their stores. So it really relieves a lot of pressure. So what the FFL API does is it finds a federal firearms license dealer, and the firearm store owner can have this integrated onto their store at the point of checkout. Doesn't matter if you're on BigCommerce, WooCommerce, Magento, Shopify. We have integrations built already with all of them. And what this does is it allows the firearm owner to ensure that they're going to be shipping to a licensed, an active licensed federal firearms license dealer. Before in the past, they never had a tool like this. They were getting a ton of shipbacks because they would ship the item over to the FFL dealer. Turns out their license was not active. It was expired. They had to then ship it back. And now your customer is there sitting waiting saying, where is my firearm? So it was definitely a large pain point that a lot of firearm dealers online were facing. And so far, great results.
So what we did was very basic. There was no centralized system or API for all the active federal firearms dealers out there, for the active FFLs. And ATF posts a list on maybe every 2 months or 3 months. So we just integrated with that. Every time ATF updates it, we grab that list and we push it to our API and we validate the active, if that FFL is active or not. And we just integrate it with your Shopify, BigCommerce, Magento, WooCommerce checkout. It's a very basic functionality, like I said, microsas. Now, the biggest problem that we're solving here, I believe, is that it's a centralized solution. It maybe took us 150 hours to build this solution. So it's not crazy expensive. And it solves a lot of problems in terms of the operations of an FFL dealer or the firearm seller, as well as it also addresses the rules and the regulations that you need to abide by as a gun seller or a firearm seller. We've built probably 9 or 10 solutions like this. So who are we addressing this specific search session to? One, if you're an e-commerce business, and if you own an e-commerce business on Shopify, BigCommerce, Volusion, Magento, whomever out there, you might have a business problem. That's as basic as, for example, we built one for Shopify. It's tax exempt, right? Shopify does not have a tax exempt app where you can, if you're a B2B company, you're selling B2B and B2C, you want to track which of your clients that log in are tax exempt and which ones are not, because it's very annoying for me to go back and try to purchase from your site if I've already given you my tax exempt documentation, right? So how do you know at the checkout if I'm tax exempt or not? Very basic functionality, probably took $3,000-$4,000 for us to build, solves a bunch of headaches for the next 36 months for you, right? This is if you're a business owner. If you're an agency, if you are a marketing firm, if you're a development firm, there is crazy potential in e-commerce apps on add-ons and SaaS solutions, because if you find that niche and if you develop that niche for a specific industry, just like we said, federal firearm dealers for the firearm industry, tax exempt for B2B companies. There are literally thousands of these functionalities. Just go to our site, optimum7.com/custom-programming, or just type on Google Optimum 7 Custom Programming. You're going to see 700 functionalities we built like this. So if you have an opportunity like this, this is the time to leverage that opportunity, especially if you're in a specific niche or specific industry. Now, at Optimum 7, again, Joe, we've built these before. Let's talk about the pricing of these. If somebody comes to us and says, hey, guys, I have this business problem, or as an e-commerce owner or as an agency, I have 200 clients in this vertical, and I think that if you build this, I can sell to all 200 of them because everybody's experiencing this problem. When we're looking at something like this, what is the cost? What are we looking at in terms of cost?
Well, it depends on, like you said, is it going to be a simple integration? Do we have a database that we're going to be pulling information from? The complexity of the app or the SaaS itself? Again, that's all going to be broken down into hours. Obviously, at the end of the day, if we see more opportunity, we might charge a little bit less up front because we see that there's a lot of opportunity to then resell this app to other other businesses that are facing the same pain point. But I would say that this can run you anywhere between on the low side, $30,000, on the high side, $80,000.
Yep, got it. So if it's just a TextExM basic functionality, it could be a few thousand dollars. But if you want a true app or a SaaS solution, you're looking at, you know, a minimum of, I would say, $20,000-$30,000, and it can go up to $100,000. So if you're thinking about adding a specific functionality to your e-commerce site, or if you're an agency or a marketing firm and you are thinking about building a specific e-commerce SaaS or add-on for Shopify, BigCommerce, any kind of app, any kind of add-on plugin for WooCommerce, reach out to us. We'll talk to you guys next week.